The first check we ever wrote at Tool Shed Brewing Company, check 001, went to Cask Global Canning Solutions, which was pretty neat because when we did this research and we found out the glory of the can for beer, there's this one company who invented the craft canning machine and makes the best craft canning machines in the world, and it's right here in our city. It seems too good to be true almost, right?
Cask basically invented micro canning, and I think now we're reinventing micro canning. You know, we're continuing to innovate every product we have. This is a craft industry, but I think craft beer and science can coexist.
There's a lot of lessons to be learned from both sides by working on a machine and doing that R&D in an actual brewery.
One of the things I'm really excited about with the new V5 is a lot of the problems that we've solved in the V5 have come directly from our customers. Things have been identified by customer visits, by customer suggestions have been integrated right in the machine.
One of the reasons I love working with Cask is the R&D part of it, is when there's a problem and something's not working, and we'll have 3 or 4 solutions, and then from there we decide what's the best solution.
One of the things we really wanted to nail in this machine was to make changeover simple, repeatable, and get you back up and canning. Because, you know, you're not making money when you're changing over. So when we set out to design this new machine, we decided, you know, let's make this thing able to handle just about any can you can buy commercially. The fill head on the machine doesn't need to be changed. It's universal from anywhere from a 202, even a 200 end, all the way up to a 211 body can with a 202 end. Check your seams and away you go.
So the spindle themselves, they've been working fine, but we always need to improve. We can't just leave it as is. Originally they have been aluminum, and we decided the best thing for us to do is change it into stainless. And with this one now, we actually do the assembly here. The bearings, the spindle itself, we now make this as one assembly, and everything is dialed right in so that our seams are that much more accurate. All the spindles for Cask have 100% inspection. The runout will be no more than 2,000 of an inch.
With the new cam-driven seamer, we're really trying to eliminate variability and bring a bunch of repeatability to the process. It'll allow you to really dial your process into the middle of the process window and be able to, you know, run all day. We decided to develop a scale, you know, integrated it right after the seaming position. On the screen, on our HMI, we have, you know, real-time trending of the weights of the cans coming off, so that, you know, long before you start getting rejects, you can react and make small adjustments down to the hundredth of a second to bring yourself right to the middle of the window. Nitrogen dosing becoming much more common in the industry really took that into account when we designed this machine. So, you know, you wanted to do nitro dosing, okay, we just add, you order it, we add it onto the machine. Your dose time to seam time is going to be always within, you know, several milliseconds. People that are doing mobile canning, they're servicing many breweries. Wheels are available on it. That makes it easy to wheel into just about anywhere. It's a nice small footprint. You can get it into just pretty tight spaces, honestly. We've taken it from a 3-phase machine down to single phase because, you know, we know sometimes 3-phase power at that voltage is difficult to come by. We've reduced the air consumption on the machine substantially. So, you know, if you get a power hookup and a small compressor, you can run this machine in just about any brewery. You know, another thing we've heard from customers in the past is, you know, our machine doesn't handle it well when there's a lid missing from a can. So we've integrated a sensor, you know, right before we seam, so that if there's no lid, we don't seam. We don't get cans stuck on the chuck anymore. It just passes through the machine and rejects it.
Anybody who looks at a canning machine from Cask knows that years of not just research and development, but research and development in close quarters with a brewery that uses it every single day, is why that machine is going to market in the best possible way to help other breweries.